Hi everyone, my name is Brie and I am a speech pathologist that specializes in AAC. And this past year, I have been providing virtual therapy to a group of complex communicators. And GoGo Speech has been a lifesaver with their awesome, awesome activities. In order to supplement those activities with my device users and being able to model and provide aided language stimulation to teach them their systems, I often accompany my session with some emulator software. So I wanted to provide some tips to you today if you're working with this population or with a population that requires some visual supports. So if you have an AAC user, most high-tech devices have a free program that accompany it that you can get on your computer that then allows you during your teletherapy session to provide that aided language stimulation. And I'm calling that emulator software. What you see next to me today is the emulator software for PRC Sautillo products. It's called Pass New Voice Software, and if you download that, it's free. You can support your kids using this program. The most common vocabulary system they have, you know, is Lamp Words for Life, but they also have a bunch of different vocabularies. So here I am emulating Lamp Words for Life, and as I support my AAC users during this teletherapy session, I can provide that modeling. So here in our dinosaur activity, I can tell them, hey guys, we're gonna go on an adventure. Should I? And then I can go over here to my talker. Should I open? And I can click through, open the door. And then to their surprise, we open the door and we're somewhere special. The other thing I love about emulator software, specifically the Pass New Voice software, is that I can provide visual supports on the fly. I use this with my kids using LAMP and other PRC Sautillo vocabularies. But I also use it with my kids who just need some visual supports. So here I can do a lot of modeling, but there's this option up here that I can do. I can go to vocabulary display options, and this write with icons option. I can decide the size I want my icons, and automatically it will say instructions on page. I turn that off and then press OK. So now I just have like a blank screen next to me, but as I'm going through that activity, I can say, oh, I wonder where I am. And look at this car. Who does it belong to? Can we ask that question? And then all I have to do over here is I click in the box and I type whatever core word or fringe word I want to support my kiddos with, and I press enter. And the path to where that word is in this system comes up. So that's really powerful to model for my kids and give them visual supports, but also to support my parents to figure out where words are and model for their child. So then the kiddo will say who, and all of a sudden we'll see that someone appears. And we'll go through the activity like that. I absolutely love this emulator software, even for kiddos that are verbal but just need visual supports. And I'll show you that in a sec. So as we go to the activity, he'll come down and we'll say hello to him. And then we'll say, oh, he wants to go on a dinosaur hunt. Do you think we should go? So if my child's a LAMP user, I can then provide them some choices here on the fly. Yes, enter, no, enter. And that shows them the path to say yes or no in their device. But if they're not a device user or a LAMP user, I can just provide them those visual supports. So what I can do is I can click here and delete the beginning of the path. And now I just have visual supports on the fly. And I don't have to create them ahead of time or have like little paper to pull or anything like that. I just have the visual supports right on the screen. The other thing I absolutely love about this is I don't have to plan ahead too much because I can have those supports on the fly. So I have my activity, and then at whatever point the child is most engaged in the activity, I can pause and provide them some core vocabulary or some answer choices, or if they are really using the vocabulary I'm emulating over here, I can provide them some aided language stimulation. So it's really fun to be able to use this software along with GoGo Speech's activities. If we go a little bit further, so I'm going to clear this out here. We decide we're going to go on a dinosaur hunt. So I can ask the kids, you know, do you think we should go? And then I provide them that visual support so they can say it on their talker. And when they say it, we decide to go. See? But, oh, wait. Uh-oh. Look at his face. Oh, he sees the caution sign for dinosaurs. I wonder how he's feeling. A lamp user, this would benefit because I can give them answer choices and they can learn where the word is in their device. So is he feeling happy, sad, or worried? And now it teaches them the path or the parent the path to be able to say that word when I give those answer choices. Again, if my student's not using this vocabulary, but I just need some visuals on the fly, I can go over here real quick after I type that in, delete the beginning part, and I have three on-the-fly visuals to support my child in making a selection. This program is amazing, especially that vocabulary writing on the fly. So definitely check it out and use it to supplement with your GoGo Speech activities.